you'd like, what you can use is one of these tapered calls. They're just long and flat that we used for the process of, I usually don't, but I will right now. So then, I'm gonna have this call here. We'll wanna have some kind of call. I hope you guys figure out what kind of call would be good for your guitar. And I'll have this call for the back. And I'm gonna have one orange Jorgensen F clamp, because they're better. There. So clamp it. So you wanna have access to the entire perimeter of your soundboard, where it touches the perimeter of your fingerboard, where it touches the soundboard. And that guy is gonna go there. And then I will get one of these clamps, these little clamping calls, and I'll put it underneath on your webbing strip. And watch closely how you make these enter. So you don't want to start smashing up your sound hole now. Putting dents all over it. You'll feel it. A little bit of a loser. One goes there. One goes there. And you can also put another clamp if you can. It depends on the distance from your sound hole to your fingerboard. But in this case, I think I should be able to fit one of those little blue clamps. I've got a bunch of little blue C clamps. So you got two there for your 7. James, I see one in your bench. This. It'll fit. Yeah, it fits nicely, so I'll put that one there. Great! I've got all my clamps. Before you put the sound hole clamps in, you'll want to make sure you get your bolt in. Here you go, you ready?
6 minutes.
Spread a nice thin film of glue. Don't worry about squeeze out at all. All gonna be fine. One thing I did not do that I wanna do, just quickly, just rub that perimeter there, and yeah, just enough to smooth it, because I don't want to have any sharp edges. Should be good. Okay, so now Put these in. Perfect spot. Very nice. Now, I'll apply the glue to my little veneer. So I put it on upside down. Make sure your left and right are properly taken note of. And then, put glue on both sides. And again, you want to make sure that you have it inside that perimeter. The last thing you want is this thing to move on you. It will drive you nuts because you'll have to take it all apart. And you'll have to redo it all. There you go. Pretty confident with how it's sitting. Now, the cool thing is there's no glue in the dovetail. So at this point, I'm not really too overly concerned about time. I am concerned about time, but not as much as I would be if I had glue. If you're putting glue in your dovetail at this stage, my neck would be glued already. It sets in, and so then have it so it's directly on top of the dovetail. That's it. One more crack. There. That's pretty okay. So now at this point, I'm just gonna quickly do a little inspection. Looks like everything's sitting where it should be, so I'm pretty happy with that. I'm going to take one. It's calling a move colder a little. It's nice if you actually have a call that's smaller than your fingerboard is wide. Because then you have easier access to your perimeter. That's good. Then, take my bolt. Carefully get it in place.
How tight do you want it?
Fairly taut. You don't want to like imagine yourself pulling that brass fitting out. It's a seatbelt. That bolt is not really what's keeping the neck in place. It's the tight dovetail fit. So now before I put the rest of those clamps on, I'll make it easier on myself. Get one blue cloth, a little bit of water. Not soaking wet, but like pretty wet, not dripping. As long as you don't have any open wood, water really won't damage your finish. So just don't worry about the polyester, it can handle it. Same with water-based lacquer or nitrocellulose. You know, it can be wet for a short period of time and do absolutely no damage whatsoever.
You're playing your guitar in the rain?
What's that?
You're playing your guitar in the rain?
Yeah, that might not give you the effect you'll want, but and don't do this in the rain. But if you want to zoom in closely on the side here, just take a look at how it's sitting. It's sitting pretty nice.
Looks pretty okay. Now, I still see a gap at the end of the fretboard, which is why I'm gonna clamp it a little bit more.
So.
Poncho.
You know, I'm gonna switch it up a little bit. I'm gonna stick with this. This is good. And sometimes I'll glue the, I'll put the clamp on the upper transverse as well, if you do that. But you do damage that brace a little bit, you'll leave clamp marks in it. Again, don't smash up your soundboard.
So, do you do the same kind of a thing with the saddle, with the router and everything?
Similar, but we won't be putting a veneer in between. It'll be just straight wood-to-wood contact.
Yeah.
And but we will be routing a lip around the perimeter of the bridge itself.
So it fits in like...
You got it. It'll be like a puzzle piece. It'll snap into place. And the way this is going to be clamped is not going to be symmetrical, but I'm getting good clamping pressure this way, so this one's a little more forward. I'll put this one right here. If it ends up fitting. So, this one here, it's close to the end of my sound hole. I don't want to crack my sound hole, so this little one's not that tight, it's just taut. And then I'll wipe up all the squeeze out with this.
The DVD.
What's that?
Jeremy
Adams.
12 Days Banana Course. Taut, not tight.
Taut, but not tight.
That'd be good on a shirt. Taut, not tight.
And then a little piece of vinyl. I think this is nice because it's got a square edge. So you can wrap it in the cloth that's wet. Wipe up and squeeze it with that. And this side. I think good. I think it looks pretty nice. And it looks like it's nicely centered.
So the next time that neck comes off should be about 30 years?
Yeah, hopefully. Sometime around then. You never know. Sometimes it's 20, sometimes it's 40, 60. But